As developers, we fear working with legacy code because it is difficult to understand, modify, or extend. The good part is you can refactor your code bases to improve its design or structure. I know we avoid refactoring because it can break our existing code. In this screencast, we'll look at how IntelliJ IDEA can help you to refactor your code safely with extract variable refactoring. We'll also talk about some of the do's and don'ts because refactoring is not a magic bullet. In this code, let's extract the highlighted expression to a variable. You can use the shortcut keys Ctrl-Alt-V on a Windows system or Command-Alt-V on a Mac. Depending on your context, IntelliJ IDEA suggests a default name for the extracted variable, which you can change. You can choose to define this variable as final or by using var. For this example, I'll choose both of them. Option to use var during extraction is new to IntelliJ IDEA 2019.1. Also, var was added in Java 10. So you should configure project language level to 10+ in IntelliJ IDEA, which is available with JDKs 10 or higher. By extracting a part of the expression into a new variable, the original expression is easy to read and follow now. Now let's work with a comparatively complex example which uses current date and time to return a unique string in a predefined format. Most of the work is being done here by the return statement. It concatenates a string value and date time components. However, over time, it might become difficult to follow all this logic. So let's simplify this expression by extracting its parts to variables. Select the string literal j and extract it to variable prefix. Now, select the expression that extracts year for local date time instance. IntelliJ IDEA suggests an appropriate name. Now, let's extract the highlighted expression to a variable. This expression returns month using two digits. For months that have a single digit, it prefixes them with zero. Let's extract this expression to a variable too. Let's rearrange the modified expression to see how easy it has become to read and follow. IntelliJ IDEA is quick to detect if the expression that you are extracting into another variable is duplicated in multiple places. If it is, then it offers to replace one or all the occurrences of the selected expression. You can also change the default variable name suggested by IntelliJ IDEA. You can find complex expressions in various places, like a field initializer. With IntelliJ IDEA 2019.1, you can also use extract refactoring with complex expressions in field initializers. Interestingly, Java compiler also moves the initialization code from your field declarations to instance initializers. IntelliJ IDEA 2019.1 can convert ternary operators to if-else statements in select cases. As developers, we would need this conversion because a ternary operator can become complex, especially if it includes checks, such as instance of or null for a variable. In such cases, IntelliJ IDEA can help you extract a variable and also replace the ternary operator with an if statement. Besides modifying the name of the extracted variable here, the real value of this extraction lies in how you could modify it further in your code. Automatic refactoring is not a magic bullet. To use variable refactorings in IntelliJ IDEA effectively, you must know when it works safely and when you need to exercise caution. Let's understand it using this code. Before I refactor, let's quickly execute and see the output. Here it is. Now, let me extract emp.title into a new variable and replace all its occurrences. It can output unexpected results because of the runnable here. which might execute before or after I call the log method. And here's the output of the modified code, which is not what we expected. Let's work with another example. When you extract an expression that includes a method call, IntelliJ IDEA lets you choose whether you want to replace just one occurrence or all of them. Be careful in such cases. Such extraction may change your code behavior irrespective of whether the method call that you extract into a variable is pure or not. In this case, getTimeNow was extracted to variable timeNow, which is used twice. This code will always return value 0 as the execution time, no matter how long the loop takes to execute. Before you get started with some serious refactoring of your code, please ensure you have an automated test suite set up to ensure all the functionality is still the same after the modifications. You can use IntelliJ IDEA to help you get started with defining unit tests. Happy refactoring and thanks for watching!